Hi, it's Doug. These are my favorite pajamas. They're awesome. They're even realistic. Check this out. This is a model of the human hand, and there's the pajamas right there. It's pretty detailed, isn't it? Someone named Gideon has a question about skeletons. Let's give him a call.
Hi, Doug.
Hi, Gideon.
I have a question for you. Why do our skeletons have so many bones?
That's a great question.
We do have a lot of bones. Scientists have counted them and found out that there are more than 200 bones in our body. But before we can answer why there are so many, think about this. Why do we even have bones at all? I mean, what good are bones? What do they do for your body? What do you think? Now would be a good time to pause the video and discuss. Okay, you ready? Well, when thinking about what bones do, funny enough, it might be helpful to think about a building, like a skyscraper. When people make a building, first, they start with some kind of steel or wooden beams. They create a structure, something that's in the shape of the building. And only once they've done that do they add the walls, the windows, the roof, and so on. Sometimes we even call this the skeleton of a building. Your skeleton is no different. The bones are like the steel beams of a building. They give your body its structure. Now imagine for a second if you had no bones at all. What would happen? Think about it. You'd just flop over. You'd look like this. There'd be nothing to hold you up. So that's what bones do for us. They give us a structure. But why so many bones? Why do we have over 200 bones in our body? Take your hand, for example. You can see in this x-ray of a hand, there's a lot of bones. Just in the top part of one finger, there are 3 bones. What's the point of that? Use your imagination again. Imagine if your finger had only 1 bone in it. What would go wrong? You can see there'd be nowhere for your finger to bend. You couldn't bend your finger. Each of the places on your body where you can bend something, that's called a joint. So you see, by having more than 1 bone in each finger, that allows your finger to bend. Now, think of all the places on your body that can bend. Your neck, your legs, your arms. You see, if you didn't have so many bones in your body, you wouldn't be able to move in so many ways. So, in summary, without bones, our body would have no structure. You literally couldn't stand up. And by having so many bones, that allows our bodies to bend in many places. Without that, we wouldn't be able to move. That's all for this week's question. Thanks, Gideon, for asking it. Now, we have something special for this week's episode. If you have time, my friends and I here at Mystery Science have created a step-by-step activity that combines science with art. You can find a link to the activity at the end of this video. Okay, for the next episode, I reached into my question jar and found 3 questions submitted to me that I'm thinking about answering. When this video is done playing, you'll get to vote on one. You can choose from: why do spiders bite? Do bats really drink blood? Or how can you tell if a mushroom is poisonous? So submit your vote when the video is over. I want to hear from all of you watching. There are mysteries all around us. Stay curious. And see you next week.